Hey guys, what's good, what's up, what's popping? Welcome back to the channel, and if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. It's I think 6 a.m. here. I couldn't sleep, so and by the time I checked time it was already late, so I decided to just start filming this video. As you can tell, my title is going to be a story time. A very, very traumatic story time. What is this in my head? Okay, yes, it's going to be a story time. So let's get into the video. Welcome back, and please ignore everything in the background. Yes, background noises, anything you see in the background. Just focus on me. You know what I'm saying? Back to the video. Also, this is also like going to be like a first day in uni vlog, in case anyone was asking. I don't know what I was asking, but in case anyone asks in the future, this is also going to be a first day of uni vlog. So, where do I even start from? I feel like I should be doing something as I'm telling the story time, but anyway, I got the admission to Bingham University. The name of my old school, my previous school, was Bingham University. Nasarawa Kero Ota. I got to admission into Bingham University. It was admission, but like not really admission, but like also admission. I mean, if you get it, was technically I got to admission to the IGM program in Bingham University because they do that. For those of you who don't know who the
What the fuck are you doing?
IGM program is like an A levels course that you're supposed to take for 9 months. 9 months only. 9 freaking months. Then you get admission into the school of your choice, but not 100 level, 200 level. After your IGMP program, you get admission to, you know, of your choice. It was the day of my resumption. I think that was October, if I remember the year correctly. 2019. Yeah, I think 2019. I got my stuff, I packed already. I got to the car with my dad. We left for Nasarawa. We arrived at the school. I was like, oh, the school gate looks cool. I think that should have been like my first red flag from that school, because like, that time, the school gate had 2 entrances, right? One just by the left, one just by the right. It's like going and coming, that double road system. The one by the right, the road, you know that kind of thing that happens during erosion? The whole thing had collapsed in itself because of erosion. I don't know why I just disregarded that one because of my father, but we passed the school gate now. We passed first security clearance. We now go to the hostel gate. Mind you, then I did not know there was a new boys hostel because they did not inform me. We go to the boys hostel. We are going to the boys hostel gate. Then me and my dad came down. I came down with my luggage. We met the circles at the gate. They said they would search my luggage. I was like, okay, sure. Why not now? No peep. They searched my luggage and everything now. They now signed me into my room because I had to sign my room. I had to move my luggage inside my room. My dad was like, he's going to help me. Or the customer said me, you know, like, no, he cannot help me. That he cannot enter the hostel. If I want help, I should customer to come help me. My father was talking to the porter man. The man didn't want to agree. The man didn't want to agree. In my mind, I was like, so what is this? See all this my luggage? You want me to carry all this thing myself? And you know, when you're resuming school, like, that shit, like, your luggage will be huge. One bag of provision, like 2 or 3 bags for your clothes. No, 3 bags. No, I don't know who takes 3 bags of clothes to invest. Are you mad? You get what I mean? We found somebody to help me carry my luggage to my room. First of all, the room was locked when we got there. When I saw the hostel, as we walked inside the hostel, I immediately understood why they said my father cannot follow me inside that hostel. How do I describe it to you? You know all these public bathrooms that the army used to use? That's how the hostel looks like. I don't... If I can put a picture, I'll put a picture here for you people. The room was locked at first. They were like, they were going for the guy that is staying there to open it. In the meantime, I should come and carry my bunk myself. Bunk? Is there no bed already inside the room? And I followed the man to understand what's going on. He took me to where there's carry bunk. It was a metal bunk like this one where you put all the single beds on. It wasn't new, mind you, it was welded. And I had to carry this shit on my back myself because nobody was helping me with that shit. And it was at the other side of the hostel. I carried this shit on my back. I even wonder how I did it. I followed him back to my room. When we went there, on the road, we met one tall, slender. He looked like we were doing some kind of drug or something. Looks like he escaped from prison. He now followed us to the room. I was like, why is it? Guy following us to the room? Because he was not talking to the porter. We got to the room. The room was open. So he entered the room with us. I now saw the room. Only one bed was inside the room. I was like, blood of Jesus. Blood of Jesus. There was a hole in the ceiling. The two windows at the back, one was barricaded with wood. The other one, the glass was broken. And I think they used clothes to cover it or something. I was like, God, please let this not be my room. Because the porter was talking to a lot of people and he was resumptioning. You know, I thought he was just making me follow him and everything. And the tall black guy that I said looks like just like he escaped from prison. That was his room. My mother was like, God, please let this not be my room. God, please let this not be my room. God, please let this not be my room. And I just finished praying in my mind. The porter was not like, drop your bunk here. And I'm like, I then proceeded to ask him because I wanted to be sure. Sir, is this my room? And I said yes.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine. And you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
I had no words. How do I even describe that feeling? Let's see, where you are expecting your mother to like buy you a new phone as a gift. She now bought you socks or boxers or singlet. She now bought you singlet as a gift instead of a new phone. No, that one does not compare to what I felt. Disappointment. But whatever. So I went to meet my father. My father was like, is the room good? I was like, is there, sir? He was not like he wants to be going. I sure told him outside that the room is messed up and everything. He was like, maybe you can ask them to change. I was like, okay, now let him just go because like, I know I'm stressing. I went to meet the porter. I was like, sir, please, can you change my room? I don't understand what is going on. He said, no, room assignments are final. And I went back to the room to change, to put my things beside my bunk and my bed. Let's not even talk about the bed they gave me. Across from me, it was the guy, you know, tall black, prison. He was sitting there. I made sure to put my bed as far away as possible. My bed was across from his own. Then I was afraid to leave the room because, like, I knew other people there, but I knew their rooms were far from. I didn't want my shit to get stolen, so luckily I bought padlocks. Padlocked my gun was there, padlocked my clothes back, padlocked everything as I changed. I told him I was leaving the room. I was like, okay, I will give you one key. He was the one that came first, so he had master padlock. He gave me one key, then I went to see a friend. Then I came back. Okay guys, I just wanted to like film from a different angle because I wanted to feel like all those YouTubers that like film from different angles then mash it together. You know what I mean. Anyways, so I went to see a friend, then I came back. Fast forward to the next day, because like that was when our next roommates came. Because we had another roommate, but I didn't meet him till the next day, till I saw the next one. So that was when Solomon came, my friend Solomon. They brought him into the room the first time. He saw the when I saw him, I was like, this guy looks like a middle-aged, like 40-year-old man. But that was like, he was actually very, very young. I was like, fresh meat. As if I didn't just come the day before. Solomon got settled in. So he was like quiet, keeping to himself and everything. He met the you know, tall, dark and psycho. You guys will understand why I'm saying tall, dark and psycho soon. Me and Solomon, we like exchange like 2-3 words. The tall, dark and psycho, I feel, no offense to anybody actually going through mental issues or whatever. I'm just kidding, okay? Please don't take offense to that. So, Solomon just came and it was like 30 minutes Solomon finished settling. He already started asking Solomon for provision and food and everything. He did it with me, but I was like, I gave him Asper. It's my first time now, good Samaritan. Foolish mistake. He asked Solomon. Solomon gave him a lot. I was like, you fool. You young fool.
After he asked Solomon, he now proceeded to ask me again. I told him I don't have. Fast forward to the night part. He has this small phone, this button phone. I'm not going into details about him in this story time because this is like my first day. So maybe in another story time, comment if you want part two or whatever. So he has this small phone that you always play music on. It's a button phone because like I think then smartphones weren't allowed in Bingham. Yeah, smartphones weren't allowed in Bingham, but you could use tablets and laptop, but smartphones weren't allowed. Make it make sense. But everybody used to sneak in smartphones anyway. So I think he didn't have a smartphone, so that was his only phone. So it was, I think, 12 a.m. He was playing music, you know, like to sleep now. He had earpiece, so, but when he goes to the oh my God, I didn't like talking about this. When he got to 12 a.m., he would remove the earpiece and let the music play aloud. And the rest of us in the room, we would be hearing the song. Mind you, if it was a whole playlist, okay, we're fine, we're good with it. But no, it was one song, that one fucking song. That song by XXXTentacion, Moonlight. Moonlight till 4 a.m. Moonlight playing till 4 a.m. Then I thought I was the only one that noticed. I was like, what the fuck is up this guy? I literally wanted to take that phone and shove it in a very inappropriate place. But no, where's Zen? I thought I was the only one that noticed because then I wasn't really talking to Solomon and shit like that. So it was the next day, me and Solomon started talking. So we're like, Solomon sat on his bed. He was like, but what's wrong with this guy? I was like, I don't know. I was like, why was he playing music to you? Like, I was like, guy, I thought it was everyone that noticed. So we now asked around about this, our roommates, our fellow roommates. Oh God. I was just like, everything just was like, which kind of hell did I come to? This would make me look worse or better. I don't get. No, it's making me look worse. I was like, which kind of hell did I come to? Because, anyways, I became friends with Solomon. We met the other roommates. It turns out his name was Prosper. I was a 15-year-old who had a very, 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 very vague idea of the meaning of education and misplaced priorities. I think I'm going to stop there for now because I think this video is more than 11 minutes. So like, if you guys want a part two, I'm going to do a part two. I don't know, maybe I should make this a series or something because a lot of shit happened to me in Bingham University. This is just like the tip of the iceberg. This was like my first day in uni. I didn't go to class for like 4 days or something because I didn't know my class venue and shit like that. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Leave a comment, like, subscribe and share. Please subscribe. Please subscribe.
Subscribe now.
Bye. Deuces.